So it's officially happened. Dame has requested a trade from the Portland Trailblazers. And I couldn't even be more happier for him. I really couldn't. But now there's the issue of, can he really go to the spot that he wants? Shams has reported that Dame wants to be specifically traded to the Miami Heat. And we kind of all saw that coming a mile away. I've made a video about it. Should Miami go all in for Dame? You can look at that. That'd be in the description somewhere. It'd be somewhere over here. But at the end of the day, now that he's officially requested a trade, there are still other teams who can get into this conversation, because now Portland is fielding those conversations. They're fielding those phone calls. And come to find out, Miami is not the best destination, or best team to do business with if you're the Portland Trailblazers. In fact, when you look at what the Miami Heat have, unless they are considering moving Bam or Dame and part of a trade package, they really don't have they really won't get a good return for Dame. Why do I say that? Well, Gabe Vincent has already been signed somewhere else. Max Strus has already been signed somewhere else. Most of the people who showed out throughout the playoffs that you actually could have used as leverage in this particular trade are no longer on the team. Max Strus, I believe, just got $364 million over three or whatever from the Cavs. I think Gabe just landed somewhere else in a decent contract for him. I know that those are peanuts compared to Dame's contract, but when you add them together with maybe Kyle Lowry or even a Duncan Robinson or Tyler Hero, more likely, when you add those three together plus the picks they could have, it seems more enticing, and it kind of fits what Portland is already trying to rebuild over there in the post-Dame era. However, now you don't have those pieces. Now you have to hope that the picks that you can give up just entice them enough, and that you really are in a situation where Portland is trying to be generous to just make sure that Dame lands where he wants to go for his 11 years of service there. But business is business. And if you want to sit there and be honest with yourself, you know that the Portland Trailblazers would probably get a better deal from the Brooklyn Nets, or even the Philadelphia 76ers, both of which could actually add a good player, a player of note, to the deal and have some picks. Now, the pick situation is a little different, especially within Philly. I think their picks come with a lot of protections, but they could offer the better players in the deal. Tobias Harris has been rumored to be in every trade talk this particular summer. And in fact, Tobias Harris himself has said that they would trade him he said they'd trade him for literally nothing at this point. But Tobias Harris is a good player. And he also comes with a contract that, matched with some other pieces, could be very, very valuable. You also have to consider the fact that James Harden is still a Philadelphia 76er right now. So while it may not be his ideal landing spot, business is business. And neither one of these players, in my opinion, to my knowledge, have a no trade clause. And if I'm the Philadelphia 76ers and I see that Dame is looking to be on a move, and I have two players, that one who already wants to be moved, who just opted in for $35 million, I'm picking up the phone. Hey, I have James Harden right here to help you get that off your. I have James Harden and a bunch of picks. We all know that you're not going to get a big return. Why wouldn't the Portland Trailblazers even consider it? One of the other teams that I want to sit there and throw in this hat, mainly because, one, I'm from the city, but it's a very realistic trade and one that had been mentioned before and even flirted with, the Chicago Bulls. The Chicago Bulls could throw their name in that hat. Now, I'm not saying that they have the pick situation that Miami does. They don't. I'm not saying they have even a situation that the Sixers do or the Nets, but they could offer potentially a more valuable piece as far as age and ability. That being Zach LaVine. Now, I don't want Zach LaVine traded, if just to be honest. I've been firmly against that. But I said, if you trade Zach LaVine, you need to get a good player back. And I mean a top player back. And Dame is a top player. And I can see that working. Dame has already been extended to 15. He makes about 40 next season. Dame makes 48. We do have Portland's pick for next season, I do believe, if I'm understanding that correctly. it could be a situation in which getting dealt to Chicago not only makes it easier, but makes everyone happy. And it could be the fairest trade because now you get a good young player in return for a legendary player. You get your pick back. And at the same time, you don't miss a beat in your rebuilding process because now you have pieces that could actually do something. And plus, to my knowledge, just sends that closer back closer to home and things of that nature. Now, again, I'm not for that particular trade, but I understand. And not only do I understand, it's one that actually makes one of the most sense because Zach LaVine is better than Tobias Harris. He's better than any player that the Nets could send. He's better than any player that the Miami Heat are willing to send. Understand what I'm saying there. Better than any player that the Miami Heat are willing to send. There's no sense of having Dame in Miami if you give up Jimmy. There's no sense of having Dame in Miami if you trade his friend Bam. Like everybody else, Zach LaVine is better than. I could argue he's better than Jimmy, but I mean, Jimmy just had a legendary run. I'm not going to make that stupid mistake. I'm not going to put myself in that crossfire. But, like, you can make the argument. Wouldn't be a good one, but you can make it. Like, no. You can make the argument that he has a higher upside than James Harden at this point. James Harden being older and, in most people's opinion, on the decline. James Harden has had opportunity after opportunity, super team after super team to get something done, and he has fallen flat in each opportunity, especially in closeout games. Now, you would sit there and say, well, Zach LaVine hasn't even been in those situations. You're right, he hasn't. But now I'm betting against someone who has the upside and potential versus someone who has the history and reputation of falling flat. And so now this makes me wonder, is Miami really going to be able to pull this trade off? Is Portland really going to be that generous and not get the best player or best assets for Dame? Or are other teams going to be able to actually, you know, come in and steal it? Those are the teams that are on my list. I want to hear what you all think. I want to hear your comments on it because, again, this just got interesting. This got real interesting because, again, Miami, I think, waited too long. And I hope he does land in Miami. I hope he can play with Jimmy Butler. I hope he can play with Bam. I want to see what that really looks like. But Miami is in a situation where unless they give up half the rest of the team, which then makes them as depleted as the Phoenix Suns, who are they going to play? And I really hope Portland does right by Dame. I think trading them to any of the teams mentioned is a better situation than staying there. However, they have to do what's best for them. But I want to hear your thoughts. I want to hear what you think Portland would do. I want to hear whether or not you think Dame's absolutely going to end up in Miami. Whether it's love, whether it's hate, put in the comments. May not be in there with you. Till next time.